Hey, what's up, guys? It's Dark Arm Duels, and Timothy doing a Barrel Dragon deck profiles. I'm really excited to this one because this was actually suggested to me by one of my patrons, Dean, and this is an absolutely crazy awesome deck. You can actually summon out some really amazing Barrel Dragon monsters from Blowback Dragon, Barrel Dragon, Gatlet Dragon, and even Desperado Barrel Dragon are just awesome cards to be able to summon out to your side of the field. So, without further ado, guys, don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, hit the bell on there so you can become part of Notification Squad, and definitely check out the Patreon down in the description below, just like Dean did, for all those awesome rewards like getting your name scripted in a single video, getting assigned cards in the mail, and even getting to request a deck profile every single month you're a patron, along with test hands. And definitely give Dean some love down in the comments down below for suggesting this awesome deck. So, without further ado, let's get straight on into this. So first off, we're going to be playing three copies of the old school awesome Barrel Dragon. I love this card. When I first started playing Yu-Gi-Oh, I made it my mission to find this card, and I absolutely love the way this card plays in this deck. It's very easy to summon, and it is an awesome card. You get to toss three coins, and then if two of the three are heads, you could destroy one monster that your opponent controls, which is an awesome effect just to be able to pop a card on your opponent's side of the field, and it's a really awesome nostalgic card to build a deck around. We then play three copies of Blowback Dragon, which is basically like a miniature version of Barrel Dragon. It has the ability to toss three coins, and if at least two of the results are heads, you select a card on your opponent's side of the field and destroy that target, which is still a really good effect just to be able to pop cards, but you need it so you can go into your copy of your Gatlet Dragon. We then play three copies of Desperado Barrel Dragon, which is an insanely powerful card. This card has the ability of a face-up Dark Machine Monsters you control is destroy a battle or by card effect, then you can special summon this card from your hand. And then once per turn, during the battle phase, quick effect, you can toss three coins and destroy face-up monsters on the field up to the number of heads that you got from those three coins. Then your result was three heads in a row, then you get to draw a card, but this card can't attack the turn you activated this effect. And if this card is sent to the graveyard, then you get to add a level 7 or lower monster that has a coin toss effect from your deck to your hand, which is a really powerful effect just to be able to grab a Barrel Dragon or a copy of your Blowback Dragon or any of the other cards we have in the deck that are coin toss cards are really powerful cards. But being able to grab them off this card is really, really great because it's going to give us the fusion materials that we need to go into a copy of our Gatlet Dragon. We then play three copies of my personal tech card in the deck, and that is three copies of Keeper Dragon Magic. I cannot tell you how important this card is for this deck, because what this card does is when it's normal or special summon, you discard any card you want from your hand, which is usually going to be your Blowback or your Barrel Dragon that you're going to discard to the graveyard to be able to add from your deck to your hand a polymerization or a normal spell that's a fusion spell, which is an extremely important effect to keep in mind that it can add any fusion normal spell from your deck to your hand. Then it also has the ability you can reveal a monster in your extra deck, which just so happens to maybe be Gatlet Dragon, to be able to special summon back from your graveyard a copy of either Blowback or Barrel Dragon to put them back face down on your side of the field in face down defense. Then they can be used for fusion material, but for the rest of the turn, you can only fusion summon, which is not that big of a deal because you're not going to summon anything except for fusion monsters the turn you activate this effect anyways, because it sets you up for your copy of your Gatlet Dragon and also sets you up with more monsters on your side of the field. This card is single-handedly the best normal summon in the entire deck. We then play two copies of BM4 Blast Spider. This card is a very good card in the deck too because it works with our Dark Machine package because it has the ability to once per turn target a Dark Machine monster you control and one face-up card your opponent controls, destroy them, and if a monster you control that was originally a Dark Machine destroys a monster by battle or by card effect and sends it to the graveyard, you can inflict damage to your opponent equal to half of the original attack of one of those monsters destroyed and sent to the graveyard by that Dark Machine monster, which is a very powerful effect just to be able to inflict additional battle damage and be able to set this card on your side of the field as a 2200 defense point monster. We then play a single copy of Twin Barrel Dragon, which is also a very good card in this deck because the Twin Barrel Dragon has the ability that when it's summoned, you can just select one of your opponent's cards that they control and then flip a coin twice. If the result is two heads, you destroy the selected card. It's a little bit of a downgrade from your Barrel Dragon, but you can normal summon it to your side of the field, and I just had to play one copy of it in the deck because it is a Barrel Dragon deck. We then play three copies of King of the Swamp, which is an awesome card in this deck because it can be used as a fusion material substitute of any one fusion card. Basically, if you have a copy of Blowback or Barrel Dragon in your hand, you can use this card for the one that you're missing, which is really cool to summon out your Gatlet Dragon. which is an awesome card effect just to be able to go in for additional plays. And you can also discard this card from your hand to be able to add a polymerization from your deck to your hand, which helps out the deck a lot because you will need your polymerization to go into Gatlet Dragon. So that's it for the monsters, guys. Let's get into the spells. So for the spells, we're going to be playing a single copy of Terraforming because we have a very powerful, very awesome field spell that we're running in this deck that we're going to need to get to. One copy of Monster Reborn because it's going to help us bring back our Barrel Dragons, Gala Dragons, Blowback Dragons, and even Desperado Barrel Dragons from the graveyard, which is really, really helpful for this deck. We play a single copy of Overload Fusion. Now we're getting into the cards that you can actually search with your copy of your Keeper of Dragon Magic because they're normal fusion cards. So this card can actually be searched with our copy of Keeper of Dragon Magic, which is really good because you get to remove from play from your side of the field or your graveyard fusion materials that are listed on a Dark Machine Fusion Monster card and special summon that Dark Machine Fusion Monster from your extra deck, and it's treated as a fusion summon, which is really awesome because you can actually summon Gatlet Dragon with this card because it's a Dark Fusion Monster that's a machine. So this is a really powerful card to be able to just immediately summon that card to your side of the field or summon a second one after you've already summoned the first one. We then play three copies of Polymerization. This card is a very important card for the deck because you're going to be able to search this card with your copy of your Keeper of Dragon Magic. You're going to be able to search this card with your copies of your King of the Swamp, and is a very important card for this deck to be able to grab the copy of Polymerization to go into your copy of Gatlet Dragon or one of the surprise tech cards that we have in the extra deck that happens to be a fusion monster. We then play three copies of Fusion Deployment as well. This card is like one of the most insane cards in the entire deck because it can actually special summon out a copy of Barrel Dragon from your extra or from your deck for free, which is just awesome because all you have to do is reveal a Gatlet Dragon in your extra deck and then you get to special summon out a copy of Barrel Dragon from the deck because you reveal any fusion monster from your extra deck and then special summon from your hand or deck one of the fusion materials who's listed on that card. But you can't special summon anything but fusion monsters for rest turn, but the majority of the time we're only going for Gatlet Dragon anyways, so that's totally fine. We then play three copies of Allure of Darkness because the three copies of Allure of Darkness let us draw into the deck because the majority of the deck is dark anyways except for King of the Swamp. And this card is a very powerful card just to grab additional cards from the deck to the hand because this deck does have some moments where you'll draw into like two copies of Blowback, two copies of Barrel, and a Desperado, or a copy of Allure and the two and two of the high level monsters. So they have a little bit of difficulty with getting through that, but the Allure of Darkness totally fixes that where you might draw into a Polymerization or a copy of Fusion Deployment or a King of the Swamp or even a Keeper of Dragon Magic to help your plays start rolling. We then play two copies of Foolish Burial Goods for a trap card that we're playing later. And then we play three copies of Heavy Metal Raiders. I couldn't resist playing Heavy Metal Raiders as a three of in this deck. It's a fantastic field spell for this deck and helps out a lot because a lot of the times your Dark Machine monsters don't protect themselves very well, but Heavy Metal Raiders totally fixes that because the first time each Dark Machine monster you control would be destroyed by battle each turn, it is not destroyed, and if you took any battle damage from that battle, it gains that much attack after the damage calculation and keeps the attack as long as this card is on the field. So it permanently gains that attack, which is a really insane effect that it's just going to gain all that attack points right off the bat. For example, if you have a Barrel Dragon on the field at 26, your opponent attacks into it with a Blue Eyes White Dragon, you're gonna lose 400 life points, so that Barrel Dragon will actually go to 3,000 attack points and stay at 3,000 attack points, and it won't go to the graveyard for the first attack. It also has the ability that once per turn, if a monster you control that was originally a Dark Machine monster destroys a card on the field by battle or by card effect, you can special summon any Dark Machine monster from your hand, which fixes a lot of the problems of having too many high levels in the hand, because as long as you can get one of them out on the field to then attack or use the coin toss effect to pop something, you're then going to get to special summon out the rest of them. So that's it for the spells, guys. Let's get into the traps. We're then going to be playing for the traps. We're just going to be playing two copies of Proton Blast. Proton Blast is a really good card as a two of, and it's actually Barrel Dragon's attack name. And what it has the ability is once per turn, if you activated the effect of a coin toss, immediately after this card resolves, apply the following effects based on the number of heads. If you get one head, you inflict 500 points of damage to your opponent. That's an okay effect. If you get two, you destroy an additional card on your opponent's side of the field because all of them are going to destroy something anyways. And also, if you do three heads in a row, then you can look at your opponent's hand and discard a card from their hand. Now, that's an okay effect. All those are really good okay effects, especially if you get all three of them. But the really important card, the effect of this card, is that when this card effect is, or when a card effect is activated that tosses two or more coins, you can immediately banish the card from the graveyard to treat them all as heads. So, for example, if you're trying to use your copy of your Desperado Barrel Dragon, you can banish this card from the graveyard to then make them all three heads with your copy of your Foolish Burial Goods, to then make them all three heads to be able to then pop three monsters on the field during the battle phase, and you get to draw a card as well, which is really good. We then play three copies of Call of the Haunted, because Call of the Haunted just helps out the deck a lot. This could be three copies of Back to the Front, but I like the three copies of Call of the Haunted because if my opponent does Harpy's Feather Duster this card or anything, removes it from the field and destroys it, then I can special summon out my copy of my Desperado Barrel Dragon if I wasn't already having, or if I didn't already have one on the field. I'm then going to get to special summon one from my hand, which is really helpful because it does actually benefit because they're going one for one by destroying this and then my monster, and then I'm getting another monster on the field, which is why I kind of bait the opponent out with Call of the Haunted instead of Back to the Front, which if you want to play Back to the Front, you can instead. So that's it for the main deck. Let's get into the extra deck. So for the extra deck, we're gonna be playing three copies of Gatlet Dragon. Gatlet Dragon is one of the best boss monsters in the entire deck. It has the ability that takes a Barrel Dragon and a Blowback Dragon to summon this card. You toss three coins and destroy a number of monsters on the field equal to the number of heads, and this effect can only be used once per turn, which is a really good effect just to be able to pop cards on the field, pop those monsters on the field. The only downside to this card is that if you use this card, you have to pop the amount that you hit. So you usually want to use this card when your opponent has three monsters on the field, because if so happens to have one monster on the field and you use this card, it does risk destroying itself, because you flip three coins, you hit two. This monster and the other monster are the only cards on the field, so it has to pop one and one because you hit two heads, which is a little bit of a downside. Unless they don't have a monster and you don't have a monster on the field, this card will always have to pop the amount of heads that you hit. We then play two copies of my personal tech card in the deck, and then it's two copies of Time Wizard of Tomorrow. I think this card is just too nostalgic not to play in this deck, and you guys might be looking at this deck and being like, wait, how do you even summon that? Well, it takes a Time Wizard and effect monster, but we're not playing Time Wizard in the main deck, but we are playing King of the Swamp. So you can use a Time Wizard plus any effect monster to be able to summon this card, which is really awesome because you can just use King of the Swamp plus any of your monsters in the deck to be able to summon this card. And it has an awesome coin toss effect, which I thought went very well with this deck. It has the ability to, once per turn, while you control this fusion summoned card, you can toss a coin and call it. Destroy as many monsters on the field as possible, and if you do, inflict damage to equal to half the total original attack of the destroyed face-up monsters. And if you called the coin toss right, then your opponent takes the damage. If you call it wrong, then you take the damage. This is an all-or-nothing coin toss card. It's going to end the game or win the game for you. We then play a single copy of the Darkest Dragon Doom Rider. This is a very new card that's come out recently. It's a very good card to summon because it has the ability to detach two materials on this card and then target a face-up card on the field and destroy it. And if destroyed was a monster, it can make one monster on the field control gain the attack of the destroyed monster's original attack slash rank times 300 until the next turn. And then it also has the ability that this card can attack the turn you activate its effect. And it's a quick effect. This card has a dragon monster as a material, but it can't activate it during the damage step, which is a really good effect just to give you a pop and an increase of attack points. We then play a copy of Red Eyes Flare Metal Dragon, which just burns your opponent every time they breathe, and I thought it'd be a super cool throwback card for the time that actually Joey dueled Bandit Keith, and this card is just really cool because of that aspect, because it's a retrained version, like Desperado Barrel Dragon, of Red Eyes Flare Metal. So for the other cards we're playing in the deck, we are playing a bunch of Link monsters in the deck because the Link monsters are very important. We're playing a single copy of Access Code because it can pop cards on the field, just kind of like Barrel Dragon. You can play Boral Sword, Boral Load if you want to for a little bit more budget. One copy of Blackluster Soldier, Soldier of Chaos. This card's a very good card in the deck. You can, again, change this card out for Boral Load, Boral Sword if you want to play a little bit more budget. But it has the ability, if this card is Link summon using a level 7 or higher monster, it cannot be targeted by your opponent's card effects, and it can't be destroyed by your opponent's card effects either. And if it destroys something by battle, it either gains 1500, can make a second attack, or banishes a card on the field, which is really good. One copy of Unicorn because it spins stuff, Phoenix because it pops spells and traps, one copy of Blockade Borg Blocker because it can actually get to your copy of your Heavy Metal Raiders if you need to get it back, one copy of IP Mascarena because it is a really good card to link during your opponent's turn, one copy of Cross Sheep because Cross Sheep has that fusion ability to bring something back from the graveyard, which helps out a lot, especially if I have a Keeper of Dragon Magic in the graveyard, and a single copy of Anaconda because Anaconda helps out a lot to go in for your copies of your fusion deployments, your copies of your Overload Fusion or Polymerization. So that's it for the deck, guys. I hope you did enjoy it. It's a really awesome deck, and I'm really glad that Dean actually suggested this one because it is a awesome and fun deck to play around with, as you guys will see in the test hands coming soon. And be on the lookout for those because this deck is wild and can do some really cool stuff, especially summoning like double Gatlet Dragons, double Barrel Dragons, and being able to just summon out all these really awesome cards to your side of the field. Hopefully we get more support for this deck soon, because right now we don't have all that much support, and it's a lot of tech cards to make it work, but it's a really, really fun deck when you actually play it. So anyways, guys, this is Dark Arm Duels. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, hit the bell on there so you can come part of the notification squad, and we'll see you guys in the next video. See you later, guys.